Hi everyone, Jared Nickel, Executive Director for ProjectSeaWee.com here, and I'm going to take a look at WET for the Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3. Before we begin, I just want to say that I believe I'm suffering from a mild case of laryngitis, so if the review appears to be rushed, it's just because I'm trying to blast through this before my voice gives out. So WET, what can we say about WET? Well, for starters, if you were a fan of Stranglehold, then you're going to really dig this game. It's basically Stranglehold that's been sort of polished up in a different way. It has heavy influences from spaghetti westerns and Kill Bill. And it also plays like the movie Shoot 'Em Up. In other words, it's going to be like a really rocking soundtrack as you go from one arena type area to the next, just killing and plowing down everything in your path. Gameplay is primarily broken down into two sections. You have sort of exploration, whereby you can interact with the environment. Say you can run up the side of a wall to a ledge, and then from that ledge you can, you know, jump over, say, like a large chasm. I will say that it does get a little bit cumbersome when you're in the thick of battle, because sometimes you just can't easily tell where the next platform that you can interact with is located. So that's something to be mindful of. If you hold down the L2 or left trigger, you sort of get this like ninja vision where certain objects in the environment glow red. That's basically your indicator letting you know that you can indeed interact with it. But in the thick of battle, that becomes very problematic because you can't just go ahead and, you know, okay, everybody slow down, I'm going to hold the L button now, scan, okay, there, now I can go. It doesn't work like that at all. Battles, like I said, this game is very similar to Stranglehold. So what that means is, as soon as you engage in battle, you have the ability to slow down time. Now, this isn't like operated by a meter or anything like that. The way this works is it's automatic. So like, let's say I jumped into battle. The minute I start to fire my weapon, all time slows down. And it's very, very intuitive. The closer the like one enemy is to you, one of your arms will automatically aim at that one enemy. Then your reticule, you can go and control that with the right analog stick and aim at someone else. So it actually controls really well, and it's quite an intuitive system. I haven't played something like that in quite some time. Now, no matter what you do, you honestly look like the ultimate badass. You really do. You look really, really cool. I mean, you can incorporate all of those moves I was saying before. So, like, you can zip line down, say, like, an electrical wire, or you can run alongside the walls like you can in Ninja Gaiden, or you can be hanging off ledges and firing all in slow motion as you jump off a wall. All of these things are really, really easy to do, and they just look so wicked. You take on the role of Ruby. She's basically an assassin for hire. I don't want to go too much into the story because honestly it doesn't really matter. The story is nothing but sort of like a placeholder for the rest of the game. Now, in terms of weaponry that you're looking at here, it's quite a bit of stuff that Bethesda added to the game. You've got your typical, you know, shotguns, and you've got your handguns, and it's pretty cool though later because you get crossbows and you get like a semi-automatic machine guns, which are pretty wicked. You can easily switch these weapons to and from by using the D-pad. Yes, there's real-time weapon switching. I know, it's incredible, ever since Genji. But if you can't get the sarcasm there, I'm sorry. But anyways, yeah, so it's very, very easy to switch out weapons to and from, and also to interact with all these different objects. And the reason why you want to do this is because you're going to get these special attack points. And what these do is they allow you to unlock new abilities both for your character and for your weapons. So, like, for example, you can strengthen Ruby's ability to, let's say, run along walls and shoot. Originally, you can't do that. Or you could go ahead and allocate those points off to something else, like, say, increased shotgun strength, things like that. Now, there is a heck of a lot of variety to the gameplay. Even though, like I say, each element is a little bit off, at least I found. This is going to be one of these games where I actually expect we're going to get a lot of comments from people saying, oh, you're crazy, it was amazing, and then others being like, oh man, it was garbage. I sort of tend to be right in the middle of that statement. I think the game was very well done. It's just that they should have stuck with what worked as opposed to what didn't. For example, in terms of variety, like I said, the general gameplay is from one arena to the next arena, okay? Now, there are some sections that are sort of locked off, and you have to cut away at like these little icons in order to move on to the next area and kill everyone in the area. Now, those sections, some people love. I didn't. I thought they were highly repetitive and quite annoying. Now, on the flip side, I absolutely loved some of the interactive, almost like interactive movies. There's one in particular very early on in the game where you sort of like on a highway or on a road, and there's like cars getting destroyed all around you, and you can jump from one car to the next. Yes, it's scripted, so you don't you know, do it yourself, but it's still pretty wicked to be able to jump from one car to the next, all slow motion as the car blows up. That brings up, though, another problem, which are quick time events. They pop up every now and then, and they don't feel really in place. It seems sort of stupid, like almost like tacked on, where you'll be fighting a guy with a machine gun, and then all of a sudden you see like a little X pop up, and you have to press that in order to finish him off. It just doesn't really work too well. Now, something else that does work well, again, with variety, are like where you have to jump into a chain gun and, you know, blow the hell out of everything that you see. Those sequences are really action-packed, and they really work well. Another one is where you're in a plane. As the plane explodes, you jump out, and so you have to dodge all this debris. And this is all real time. Looks great too, I might add. And yeah, so it works really, really good. But by far, the best mode, and in terms of variety, has to be the rage mode. This thing rocks. This is where basically you get blood on your face, and Ruby just loses it. The screen goes all red, enemies are black and white, and it's got a really good Mad World sort of feel to it. And again, you got this really rip-roaring like soundtrack going on in the background. I just thought it was bloody awesome, but sadly there's not enough elements like that in the game. So overall, when you take the good with the bad and everything in between, I ended up giving the game a 7 on 10, and I haven't published the review yet, so I'm still debating whether or not I'm going to give it a few points more. It's just unfortunate because what's happened is I found that I don't know, it's almost like it's a little too repetitive at times, and yet when the good moments happen, you're just like blown back going, wow, this is awesome. And that's really true for the graphics and audio. The audio I thought was superb, but the voice acting was a little iffy. There was, there was some good voice actors, but others just felt totally rushed. In terms of graphics, you'll get some wicked scenes, like the one with the airplane there. That looks brilliant. But then you get other ones where the environment's quite drab and, you know, plain, and a lot of the character animations are quite sluggish, except for Ruby. And, you know, it's just, I don't know, I didn't really dig the filter. It's got like this spaghetti western filter on it, but you can obviously shut that off, so that's not really, it's just a personal thing. So anyways, that's it. Like I said, gave the game a 7 on 10. If you read the review and you notice that it's 1 or 2 points, sub-points higher, well then there you go, but I don't think so. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and again, I apologize for the voice, and I will see you all soon. Take care.